Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Atsimba, but you can call me Atty. I'm a full-time macrame artist and small business owner. This channel basically focuses on sharing a lot of macrame tutorials as well as the behind the scenes as to what goes on in my small business. If that sounds like something that you're interested in, make sure to subscribe and don't forget to hit the notification button so you don't miss any videos. So for today's video, we will be creating this macrame wall hanging, and I really like it because it's a small, subtle way to include color into your pieces. So for this project, I am using 185 feet of my mustard 3mm cord, and of course you can find this on my website at seebytheseashop.com. And you are also going to need 6 feet of whatever color you choose. I'm using my terracotta cord, and this is in 3mm. You can find it on my website as well at seebytheseashop.com. You are also going to need a 12-inch wooden dowel. You're going to need a crochet hook. You're going to need scissors and a ruler as always, and that's pretty much it. So now let's just jump into the project. To begin this project, you're going to go ahead and cut 12 strands of the main color cord at 7 feet each. You're going to attach them to the wooden dowel with the reverse lark's head knot. We're going to go ahead and start with a square knot, so remember that's a 4 and then a backwards 4. So for this first row, we're going to do 6 square knots all the way across. For the second row, we're going to skip the first 2 strands and then do 2 square knots. Now we're going to skip the 4 strands in the middle and then do 2 more square knots. For the third row, we're basically going to create 1 in the center for each section. So we're going to skip the first 4 strands and then create 1 square knot, and again the same on the other side. Skip the first 4 strands and create 1 square knot here. Now we're going to grab the strand on the leftmost side, and we're going to use this as our leading cord to create a vertical line pointing down. We're going to go ahead and create 5 double half hitch knots. Now we're going to grab the right strand of this section and create a diagonal line to meet the one that we just created. So here we're going to create 6 double half hitch knots to close it off. Now we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Once we are done with this, we are basically going to create a diamond of square knots in the middle. So we're going to grab the 4 strands right in the center and create 1 square knot here. Now we're going to do a diagonal line all the way across. So grab the strand on the leftmost side and create double half hitch knots all the way till the center. We're going to create 11 double half hitch knots here.
Now on the other side, we're going to create 12 double half hitch knots. So now we're going to start adding in the color. We're going to take a 3-foot strand of the terracotta color cord. We're going to leave about 4 inches at one end and then start to attach it with a vertical half hitch knot. So as you can see, I'm working with 2 strands of the mustard colored cord at a time. Basically, you want to think about going from behind the 2 mustard colored strands, creating a loop, and then creating another loop around the front. So for each time that we're doing this, we're working with 2 strands of the mustard colored cord. We're going to do this all the way across. Once we are done adding the color, we're going to create another diagonal line doing double half hitch knots. Again, we're going to do this all the way until we reach the center and then the same thing on the other side. So now we're going to add another row of color, and again we're going to do this the exact same way. Grab a 3-foot strand of the terracotta color cord and attach it to the mustard colored cord with a vertical half hitch knot. And again, once we are done adding the color for this row, we're going to create two diagonal lines on each side with double half hitch knot. Now that we are done with the center of our wall hanging, we're going to cut 6 strands of the mustard color cord at 9 feet each. So we're going to grab 3 of those 6-foot strands and attach them onto the wooden dowel with the reverse lark's head knot. We're going to start creating a diamond with double half hitch knots here. So basically, I'm going to create 2 double half hitch knots going towards the diagonal left. Now I'm going to grab the center strand and create 2 more double half hitch knots going towards the diagonal right. And now I'm going to grab the left strand of this diamond and create a diagonal line with 2 double half hitch knots going towards the center. To close this off, I'm going to grab the right strand and create 3 double half hitch knots. So that is 1 diamond. We are going to create 6 diamonds total. Now this pattern will be the very same all the way down until the last one. So for the last one, again, I'm going to work towards the center, but instead of closing it off on the right side with 3 double half hitch knots, I'm actually going to switch and do 3 double half hitch knots on the left side. I'm doing this so basically it points towards the center of the wall hanging. If you forget about this, it's really no big deal, but this is just one of those things that I really like to pay attention to in my projects. So now we're going to create 6 more diamonds on the other side. When we finish the 6th diamond on this one, we do not need to change the cords. The strand will be pointing towards the center just like we wanted to anyways. So now we're going to bring the 2 arms together. And we're basically going to do this by creating a double half hitch knots with the 2 inner strands. And now we're going to create a diamond in the center. Thank you. So we're almost done with our wall hanging. I just want to add fringe to the ends of the arms. So I'm going to cut 22 strands of cord at 2 feet each. I'm going to attach them to the gaps with the reverse lark's head knot. For the last one, I just like to use this hack because sometimes it's a little tight. So basically, I just grab a bobby pin, attach the cord onto it, and then slide it in that way. Now I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. So now we just need to tie a cord so we can hang up the wall hanging. We're going to grab a 3-foot strand of cord and attach it to the wooden dowel with the lark's head knot. We're going to secure it into place with a double half hitch knot. Now we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Attach the cord with the lark's head knot and then secure it into place with a double half hitch knot. Now we're going to flip our piece over and grab a crochet hook. This is so we can hide the ends and just tuck them inside. So once you loop them through the back, you can go ahead and cut off the excess cord. Since we added some color into this piece, I wanted to kind of hide it away as well. So basically, I'm just grabbing the terracotta color cord and just looping them in the center. The final step is just to give your piece a trim. So basically, I like to do this by finding the center of my piece and then creating a diagonal line.
So that is it for this tutorial. I really hope that you guys enjoyed it. It's just a really fun way to add colors, and it kind of gives like a little weaving look to your macrame pieces. So I just really enjoy this technique, and I hope you guys did too. If you recreate this wall hanging, please tag me on Instagram. I am at cbytheseashop, and I would love to see your work. Don't forget that I will link all of the materials down below, and you can find the cord on my website at cbytheseashop.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.